No, ma'am.
Is there anything that you want to ask me? You can ask. Okay, then. Welcome back to the class and a very good afternoon. So we are going to continue with our discussions on bar graphs and histograms. All right. So yesterday we have seen what is a raw data, how an organizing of data helps us to understand the data better, and what are the two different varieties of organizing data in the form of graphs. That is one example we have seen for a bar graph and one for a histogram. This was there in the video that I have shared. All right. So today we will take up one more example and try to find out how the graphs would be different if it were a bar graph and when it is a histogram. What is the main difference between them? So I want you to take your textbooks with you now, because we are discussing problems in exercise 5.1. All right, come to page number 76. Even I have the textbook here. I did not want to project it here because otherwise you're not paying attention at all. Otherwise I could show it here also. I hope all of you are having your textbooks with you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
So I just will quickly go through the first question in exercise 5.1, because based on your understanding of a bar graph and a histogram, you should be able to answer this first question. So if you have understood yesterday's class, this should be possible. Okay. So look at the first question as I'm reading it for you. For which of these would you use a histogram to show the data? So they have given you some data and they are asking you, out of these four situations given, in which of these situations will you use histogram to represent the data? So the first one is, you want to represent the data for the number of letters for different areas in a postman's bag. So a postman is sorting it out. He's putting it differently in different bags. That is the different areas ke pakiro letter na, he is going to sort it out. So to help him sort this out, which kind of information or which kind of graphical representation can be used? Is it a bar graph or a histogram? It is just to tell the letters of different areas.
Ma'am, bar graph.
Why did you say bar graph? Why not a histogram?
Because a set of letters will be belonging to one place, ma'am. For example, he will sort them out, and one will be of Delhi's letters, one will be Karnataka's letters. So the number of letters, how many are there, we can plot them on the bar graph.
Why not a histogram is my question. Why it cannot be a histogram? When is a histogram coming in? When is it, how is it different from a bar graph? What do you need?
I mean, bar graph, there is gap, ma'am, in between bar.
Exactly. Why the gap is happening in bar graph? And
ma'am,
why
because
it is
one
not
is separate, separate.
What kind of data will allow you to put the graph in the form of bar graph? And which kind of data will allow you to put it in the form of a histogram? Yesterday I was discussing this.
Ma'am, we can.
We are talking about two different types of data.
We can put the ungrouped data into the bar graph and the group data into the histogram.
Very good. For a grouped data, the graph that you draw will be a histogram. What do you understand by a grouped data? You are putting it in class intervals. That means the information or the data that you have can be divided into class intervals easily. Then such a data will be represented using a histogram. If you do not require the class intervals, you just want the groups to be separated from each other, such a data will be represented as a as a bar graph. That's why in the first one, the number of letters, so you need the areas, the names of the areas alone, so they are not connected to each other. Area 1 has nothing to do with area 2. Area 2 has nothing to do with area 3. So they are different bars which are not connected to each other. They are not continuous. Like if you have class intervals, one bar will be attached to the next one, because the next one, the starting point is the end point of the previous bar. So they are attached to each other. So such an attached bar is where a histogram will happen. All right. So in the first case, we have decided it is going to be discrete bars, so we don't require a histogram, we just require a bar graph. Now looking at the second one, the height of competitors in an athletics meet.
Ma'am, histograph.
Why a histogram?
Ma'am, why? Because all the athletes don't have the same height.
Ma'am, Ma'am, and the data used is a group data.
Why it should be in a group data? I know, yes, group data leads to histogram.
Ma'am,
but
we
why
can
a group
group it
data?
By the heights, ma'am.
Come again, Arun, I didn't hear you.
Ma'am, we can group it, we can make it into class intervals by the height.
Yes. Again, the reason is the heights can be put into class intervals easily because you know the range. You know who is the shortest person, you have his height and you have the tallest person. And the remaining you can neatly group it as class intervals and put the members inside one of those groups, which are the class intervals, correct? So here the histogram is helpful for the representation.
Ma'am, should we write these questions in the classwork?
No need. We are just discussing it orally. If you're able to identify the data, it is enough. So that's why I'm not making you write anything. Third one,
the
number of
at least.
You can mark it there. You can mark it there. Histogram or bar graph. Okay. The number of cassettes produced by five companies. Five companies are producing some number of cassettes. You require the histogram or the bar graph here.
Ma'am, the companies are first of all different. We can go with bar graph.
Yes, because there's no connection or continuity between company one and company two. There are five companies whose number of cassettes produced are the data given to me. So it will easily get into discrete bars. That means they are not attached to each other. So they will be represented as a bar graph. Coming to the fourth one. The number of passengers boarding trains from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. at a station. The data collected is continuous or discrete? Are they connected to each other?
And they're continuous, ma'am, because from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. So many people are boarding.
Yeah.
So I think we should use a histogram.
Histogram, because it is a duration of a day. From 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. means it's 12 hours. And continuously, yes, you have to see how many of them are boarding within a defined period of time. So that defined period of time, on the time period only, 1 hour irbodu, ardha ghante irbodu, or it is going to be a 45 minutes, or maybe a 2 hours duration. So when you take the duration, it is going to be continuous. If you say 7 to 8 a.m., then 8 to 9 a.m., then 9 to 10 a.m. So all the bars have to be attached to each other because continuously for 12 hours, you are getting the data. So again, in this case also, the information is best represented using a histogram. All right. So that was what I wanted to discuss, because you should be clear where a bar graph is more useful and where a histogram has to come into the picture. All right.
Actually,
now going to the second question.
Below this question, there is a they have given that give reasons for it.
What I'm saying orally, you should be able to quote it. If you want, you write it down there, or if you think you will be able to reason out on your own, you can leave it there. Just mark if it is a bar graph or it's a histogram. All right.
Okay.
Yeah. The question two is what we are going to take up now. So I'll come back to the board. Now this you have to represent in the tabular column first. That means we have to prepare the tally marks like we have done in the previous class. All right. Now first look at the data and tell me the shoppers who came to a departmental store are marked as man for M, women in W, boy in B, and girl in G. The following list gives the shoppers who came during the first hour in the morning. So this data will be best represented as a bar graph or a histogram?
Ma'am, bar graph.
Why?
Because woman, men, boy, girl, there are four groups, ma'am. There
yes.
are four separate groups.
Yes, they are four separate groups. That's the best way you can tell. They have no connection, which is that they are not continuous anyway. So boys, yes, these many numbers, girls, so many numbers. Then
if
the men
take
and
only
the women.
Men as the only thing, then we can go with the histogram.
Yeah. Yes. So now we will draw a bar graph for this. So when you
take a histogram.
Sorry.
Now if the men were only coming to the departmental store continuously, then we could take a histogram. That is
there you have to specify if there is any duration for which you are doing the collection or the gathering of the data. All right. If you have a duration which is continuous over a period of time, then you will require a histogram to represent the
Mama,
data.
If the duration is not continuous, so when we take example as 7 to 8 and 9 to 10.
then you have nothing to tell there. It will be a two discrete bars only, because there is one duration which is not connected to the next one. So definitely there will not be attachment.
And we can say that when a histogram needs, that should be continuous, yes. And that should be one group.
Yes, there should be class intervals. Class intervals is what you are calling as the groups. If there are class intervals, they have to be continuous. Otherwise, they cannot be called class intervals at all. All right. So when you say the data is represented using class intervals, automatically it will be a histogram which will come in. Okay. So first we will do this in the board. You have to prepare the tally marks. We have already done one example. Still, I am taking up another example today. This is the one. So I'll come back to the board now. You also can keep your notebooks first ready, then only your graph will happen.
So first, let us do the tabular column, which is the frequency distribution table, right? I hope you've seen the board behind me.
Yes, ma'am.
Alright. Yes, ma'am. So we have to make the tabular column, for which you will have how many columns should you draw? First is the type of people, and then there are four varieties of people who are visiting the shop. Those are the men, the women, the boys, and the girls. So these are the visitors. Alright. So this is exercise 5.1. We are in page number 76. We are doing the second problem. We are preparing the frequency distribution table. How many of each variety has come? That is men, women, boy, and girls is what we are seeing. So frequency distribution table मने मारा होगा. Once this table is ready, we will be able to plot the bar. Alright. So come on. So the first one, in the first column, you will have the type of visitors, or you can simply say visitors. And the second one will be the tally mark. Right, neatly. You should have the frequency distribution table drawn very, very neatly. And the last column will be the frequency. That means how many in each type of visitors occur. So to get the frequency, we put the tally marks and decide how the frequency would be. So we will start. The first one is the visitor. Next one is the tally mark. And then the last one is the frequency. The tally marks will tell me what is the frequency of each type of visitor who has come there. So we will write it as women, which is W, men, which is capital M, and then girl, this is a capital G, and the boy will be capital G. So we will start with the tally marks now. Now it's a very, very simple procedure that you have to follow. When you read W there, you have to put one tally mark across W. Alright? So this you should do it very, very carefully, and you should do one entry only once. So you should be very careful. Ali W on the road, Ali cross Markovego, you want one and a half of it. So both your hands should work. Alright? You have your pencil in your left hand and you take your pen on your right hand. So when you cross that W there, the first entry or the first entry there, W, you should mark one. Alright? Then again your pencil, second W when you mark, put the tally mark one here. Alright? Now because I am away, very much far away from the table, one of you should be reading it. I will put the tally mark here. Who will take the responsibility of reading the data for me? One of you should read it before, otherwise I will call.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Aditya has volunteered. Yeah, Aditya.
So, ma'am, women, 28 members are there. Ma'am.
Yeah, right, I can read them. One by one, you should read. When you say W, I will read it here. So two times I have already said. Continue the third one.
Yes, ma'am. 28 people are there, so two bundles you should make.
I want you to read W.
I'm woman one.
I will mark a tally here. Did you not understand what I want from you?
Ma'am, I understand.
Harshavardhan will do? Who is telling me will do? Harshavardhan, yeah, start.
Ma'am, woman one.
Yes, women. I will mark. Next.
Woman.
Yes.
Woman.
Yes.
Woman.
Fourth one is girl.
Ma'am, girl. Ma'am, girl and boy.
Ma'am, it is girl.
Then
girl.
Boy.
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 Woman. Woman. Woman.
This one we can
all
make because
it
is done. When the first entry comes, make it a cross.
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone is very busy marking, is it? Okay. Then I will continue with mine. You do it slowly.
Ma'am, girl, all 12, ma'am.
No. It's not 10 like that. I want you to get used to. You will not count there and do it here. As you are taking one entry, you should put the tally marks. I want you to learn how to put the tally marks. Not count from there and write it here. Alright, see how I'm doing it. I thought it would be easy, one of the ways. Okay, girl, boy, and women. Again, woman. Then, man. Then I have girl. Again, a girl. Then man, and again a man. Then I have four times women spelling. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then I have a girl. Then I have a boy, then I have a man, then it is woman and then boy, woman, then a boy, then girl twice, yes, then man, then woman twice, then two times a man. Then two times a woman, then again a woman, then man, then woman and boy, then woman and girl, then man, woman, man. Now I think women there are four. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then girl and then woman. Then two men and two women. Then man, woman, girl.
Ma'am, blur was coming. Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, blur.
Woman, man. They are coming back, I'll come back to you. Girl, woman, man. Man, boy. I think I am done with it. I don't know if I've missed any entry. For women, I'm getting.
Ma'am, 28.
24, I'm getting. 10, 15, 20. 28.
I'm actually women at 28. Yes,
28, ma'am.
20.
Ma'am, girl 12.
Women is 24, I'm getting, my dear. Am I wrong somewhere? Men is 15. Just check if I've missed any entry.
Ma'am, girl 12.
12 girls and 5 boys.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, but woman is wrong, ma'am. It's 28.
28, ma'am.
How many are going to come from the ending?
Yes, ma'am, 28.
28, 29. 58, is it over 58 or 60?
Ma'am, you have written the tally marks as 28, but the frequency you have written as 24.
28
or 29?
I have 4.
All 60.
29. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, and 4, I have 29. 24, 5. What is the total number of entries? Please count the total there. I have
remaining 60. What are you doing? Total will be 60.
Total
I'm 60.
No, I'm getting a 58 only.
Total number is
60.
Yeah,
so we have
missed something somewhere. Are you getting a 28 here? Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so this should be represented in the form of a bar graph now. So we will draw the bar graph on the graph sheet. I am not drawing it on the graph sheet, but you are expected to draw it on a graph sheet. Right? So what will be the x-axis and what will be the y-axis you have to decide. Tell me what's the PM on the x-axis and what on the y-axis. We have the frequency and the visitors, the variety of visitors. So what will you have on the x-axis?
Ma'am, on the x-axis, the visitors
Ma'am, visitors will come on
the
x-axis and...
On the x-axis, so first you will mark the x-axis, the horizontal axis, and the vertical axis.
And
then
number of visitors will come on y-axis.
The number of visitors, right? The y-axis. Now, you will choose four different what? Four bars to represent women, men, girl and boy. The length of the bar will be decided by the frequency. So first you will write that you have the visitors on the x-axis. And you will have the number of the frequency in the y-axis. Alright? So, and then you see the number is 28, 15, 12, and 5. So, this is the best way you can take it. Maybe 1 centimeter will be equal to what is the scale? I told you the scale in a graph is very important. On the right side corner, you will write the scale. Y-axis, 1 centimeter equals. How many units do you want to take
care? Ma'am, it is not saying.
Ma'am, when we take 2 also, it will be a little long.
Yeah.
Ma'am, I think we can take 10.
Five. Will be too small, no? I think 10 will be too very small. Okay, if you think 10 is fine, you can go for a 10, 20, 30. Only 3 centimeters you will have. Instead, if you take them 5, 10, 15, 20, you will at least go to 6 centimeters.
So okay, ma'am, then we'll take 5 only because it will be smaller.
1 centimeter is equal to 5 units. So this would be minus 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. You still want to do it as 10, 20, 30, it will be too small a bar graph. Alright, now we will fix the bars. Here also you will take equal length because we need 4 bars. Take the first bar here, and the second bar here, third bar here, and the fourth bar here. So, the first bar, the length, that is the number of women is 28. So, I know it will be between 25 and 30. go to the third division. Here it is 5, 10, 15, no? So 6 divisions after 25 will give you the 20 minutes. So this is your first bar representing the women. Maybe you can think of shading it.
Mama, can be the width of the bars and the gap between the bars can be, it will be equal.
But if it is uniform, it is always looking neat. That's all.
Yes, ma'am. I asked you 1 centimeter gap and the width of the bars also 1 centimeter.
On the graph sheet, it is very easy to leave one square and move the next one. It's very simple that you do the graph sheet. The second one is 15. For
ma'am, 15. Man.
The second bar can mark it for 15. It will be like this. This is the men. Okay, you can shade it in a different way, maybe. Okay, I put dots here. Alright, then the third bar represents the girls, which is 12 in number, G.
12.
So the fourth square after 10. The smaller square here.
Middle.
Not 15, it is 12, no. 12 and a half will be middle. So one square less than 12 and a half. Because it's a graph sheet for you, it will be much more easier. For me, I have to calculate here approximately and quickly. So the goal is 12 in number. Maybe still slightly below. Okay, so this you can shade it differently. Think of putting some dark here. Okay, so that was the third bar. And then the fourth bar
is boy.
Five.
Boy.
Five. That is very simple because five is the fastest that you want. I can shade it differently. Maybe I can think of mine. That represents the one. So this is how the graph should be ready. The scale is gone out of my area, so I write it here scale. Y axis. 1 centimeter equals 5 units. Right? So this is how your bar graph is written. Clear?
Excuse me, ma'am.
So we'll go to the next one now. Next data given.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Yeah, tell me.
Ma'am, I have done this before you have started this, ma'am. Before you gave the homework, no, ma'am. At that time only I had done this.
Okay. So?
Ma'am, because, and the scale I took is 1 centimeter is equal to 2 units.
That's all right. If you use a different scale, you should have marked it accordingly. That's perfectly all right. You can show it to us. Can let us see your graph? How different it is from ours? Maybe I have to talk on here. You can switch on your camera and put on the presentation I have blocked. Yeah, Kushala is showing us her graph sheet. You can pick up the screen and see. Alright. The x axis and the y axis have you marked? Alright. Okay, good enough. But keep that B, W, G and all visible. This is not very clearly visible to me. Have you marked it? Men, women, girl and boy? Okay, good. Okay. Alright, that's fine. Okay, now going to the next data. We have to complete the histogram for the next question also. So look at the next question, I'm just reading it. The weekly wages of 30 workers in a factory are given. So there are some wages of various workers in a factory given. Using tally marks, make the frequency table with intervals as 800 to 810, 810 to 820, etc. Okay, so which is the lowest wage? Please look at the data and tell me. The lowest wage. The minimum wage for a worker. Go through the data quickly and tell me which is the minimum wage. What is the minimum wage a person is getting?
804.
Yes?
Ma'am, 804 is the minimum wage.
And what is the maximum wage?
Ma'am,
804.
Ma'am, 890.
890, ma'am.
890.
Ma'am, 898 is the maximum, ma'am.
98
is there? Yes, ma'am, 98 is there.
Yeah, correct.
Ma'am, actually 892 people are getting.
So the minimum pay is 804 and the maximum is 898. Can you see? So where will your class interval start from? You want the size of the class interval to be 10 units. 800 to 820. So like this, where will your class interval start? Because 804 is the lowest. So where will your class interval start from?
800. Ma'am, I have a doubt, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, 800 to 810, and after that, ma'am, 811 to 820.
No. Can we continue? If you say 811, then it becomes there is a break. The bar will not be attached. You should have continuous class intervals. Only then there is a common space where the two bars are getting attached. At 810, both the bars will get attached. Then 860 to 870, then 870 to 880, and then 890 to 900. So how many class intervals do you have?
I think I raised my camera, so it's not taking the lower area.
How many class intervals are there found in Delhi?
Ma'am, 10.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Are there nine class intervals? Yes or no? Why nobody is speaking? What are you people doing?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Nine class intervals are there.
Yeah, I think 60, 70, 80, 70, 80, and 80, 90. No. Did I skip one? 70, 80. Sorry, there will be 10 class intervals. Sorry, I skipped one. This is 880 to 890.
Ma'am, there should be 10 intervals.
Sorry, 890 to 900. There are 10 intervals that you will have. Right? I think I'll show you all the 10. Let me bring down my camera because I've gone below the table. See how it looks now. Yeah, I think you should be able to see the all the class intervals now. More so. And if you don't see me, it is okay. Yeah. One more is missing. Oh my God, I'm not able to accommodate in my camera. Okay. When we come to the last interval, we can see that there. Okay. So extend your lines like this. There should be 10 intervals that you get. Now, how many
you mark the tally marks here? What should you do to get the tally marks? You have to read the data there and put it in the group. Now there is a problem. Some of one, I think one or two of you have asked this problem to me already. Suppose my first entry is 830. 830 anna tally marks agi nan elli hakli. Shall I put it in the third group or the fourth group? In both the groups I have 830. Where will I put the tally marks? Think and tell me.
Middle.
830 nange third group allu kanustide. Fourth group allu 830 ide. So nan 830 anna where should I go and put the tally marks? The first entry is 830. Elli hakbeku. थर्ड ग्रूप अल्ली सेरिसोरो इल्ला फोर्थ ग्रूप अल्ली सेरिसोरो एनी ऑफ द ग्रूप्स यू कैन पुट इट देयर इज नो रूल दैट यू शुड पुट इट इन द थर्ड ग्रूप और द फोर्थ ग्रूप ओनली बट फॉर कन्वीनियंस ऑलवेज वी टेक इट विद द अपर लिमिट वी स्टार्ट 830 अंडर आवर अपर लिमिट अंडर ये लेफ्ट साइड अल्ली रोल अपर लिमिट ऑफ द क्लास इंटरवल द राइट साइड अल्ली रोल लोअर लिमिट सॉरी दिस इज द लोअर लिमिट द लेफ्ट साइड अल्ली रोल लोअर लिमिट दिस इज द अपर लिमिट So if you start with taking the lower limit, you should always take the lower limit. If you start with marking here, 840 banda ka illet hoga, 850 banda ka illet hoga, illet hoga. So we will start with the upper limit, that is 830 will come to group 3. What is the second entry there? 835. 835 illet banda ko, it will come to the fourth group. If you want, draw these lines also, so that There is no confusion between them. All right, if you be able to do the tally marks now. So, only but there is upper limit. Yes, 830, 820, 830, 840, 850. These numbers bandaga, we will go far. Always take it on the upper limit. What's that? So, will you be able to complete the tally marks and the frequency on your own? Or should I still help you? Mubastira tally marks, sir. Yes or no, something you have to tell me, no?
Ma'am, we will only do.
Okay, so complete those tally marks. And how will you know that you have marked it properly? Tell me how many workers are there in the problem given? 30. So when you add all your tally marks here, the tally marks all add to 30 per day. That is how you cross-check and see whether what you are doing is correct or not.
Ma'am, but sometimes it can be like this. For one group, it can be less, and another group, it can be more. Then it will it will become 30. But the groups, the frequency of
groups may be different, but the total should tally. The groups may be different. Why I tell you? Some of you would have taken the upper limit, and somebody would have taken it in the lower limit. So that can be that is agreed. That nobody can deny. But always your total should not be. If there are 30 people, then your total of the frequency should be 30 only. Alright? Only to maintain uniformity, I'm telling you, always maintain the upper limit. Alright? Is that clear?
Is that clear? For this, how we can take the scale?
How you can?
We can take it. Ma'am, we can take it by 10, no, ma'am, for this.
What 10? 10 only I have
not. Scale, ma'am. For the graph, we need to take scale, no, ma'am, for this.
So what?
Now we can take a 10.
Where shall I go and mark the 800? Yeah, for that only I am coming to the other side of the board. Now look at the scaling that I have taken. Suppose your graph was like this. You wanted to start. What will be there on the x-axis then? In this, what
will x-axis, we have to mark the groups. 800, 810.
There is a name for that, no? Class interval. On the x-axis, you will have class interval. Right? And on the y-axis, what you would have? Frequency. Right? No? So, frequency in Indian, maybe it will be a single digit or a two-digit number. Because totally there are only 30. Okay? So, your x-axis is what you have to think now. The y-axis 1 centimeter equal 1 unit or maximum 2 units per mole. Alright? So y-axis 1 centimeter equals 1 unit will allow you to put the scale. Or if you want to reduce the size of the graph a little, maybe 2, 4, 6. That means 1 centimeter is equal to 2 units should be allowed.
Then 30 squares will be needed for the graph, no, ma'am?
Why 30? The total only is 30, no. See, each group you will not have 30, na. Between 800 and 810, you are not going to have 30 people. All that together will be 30. So each group maximum 4 or 5 or sometimes 10 or 12 may be there, depending on which group you are talking about. 30 alone magal. If one group itself has become 30, then how your total become to 30? Are you following now?
Yeah, ma'am, I asked for the scale. Here you told that 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit.
Now, in the x-axis, you will have a problem because the radius are starting from 800 to 810. So, what you will mark here is, look carefully. So, you will see this is your 0. Maybe here will be 2, 4, 6, 8 on the y-axis. That is fixed. Now, when you come to the x-axis, you have to start from 800, 810. 820, 830, etc. So you have to go till 900 because your last upper limit is 900. Now between 0 and 800, you must be wondering how after 0 I am getting 800. So in this case, actually in the graph, we are not showing the complete graph. So here we will put a pink, a mark like that. It means this portion of the graph between 0 and 800 is not represented to be here. This graph only has a class into 800 in the next row after it. It is starting from 800. So between 0 and 800, there is no necessity for me to show that portion of the graph. So in such a case, we call something as a pink. Pink means the discontinuity. That means that portion of the graph is hidden. That's why we use this pink to show that. Alright, so just maintain a thing there and then you are starting your class interval from 800 and after that every next position will be 10 units. 800, 810, 820, 830, etc. It will go on till the last one, which will be 900. Follow? So now will you be able to complete the graph? You will get a beautiful histogram when you complete this graph. Do you think or are you confident about doing it and completing it? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I think I will stop here because I've exceeded 10 minutes, I know. Let me.
Actually, there are two more questions left out. Should we do it in the rough book or
anything? Don't do anything now. I'll discuss it in the next class, maybe.
Okay,
ma'am. I'll discuss these two questions and you will show me the class maybe on Monday because tomorrow we are not.
Okay.
So Monday this should be ready and then if time allows, I'll discuss the remaining two problems quickly and then take up the pie charts. Pie charts is something more very interesting that you can show the data of a complete full whole as a circular graph. So that is more interesting also. So we will take that up in the next class.
So Mama, but pie chart, we won't have any measurements. Ma'am, if we have 100, if we have 50, we can draw a diameter and we can divide it. When we have 34% or 34 something, it is tough to mark on the pie chart now, ma'am.